I believe in God, the Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and he rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father, who will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The Father, through the Holy Spirit, has sent Christ, his Son, to dwell among us, and has made him a source of life for us. Let us raise our petition to the triune God. God of love, hear our prayer.
God of love, hear our prayer.
That the Church and her leaders may help us in our frailty and provide us with the gifts that will make us pleasing to you, we pray.
God of love, hear our prayer.
That our civil and political leaders may fill with the Holy Spirit, so that with strength and wisdom may able to serve your people, we pray.
God of love, hear our prayer.
That the wayward, the sick, the lonely, and those who suffer in any way may find consolation in those who care for them, we pray.
God of love, hear our prayer.
That our communities may be bound together in friendship and unity as we partake in the Eucharist every day, we pray.
God of love, hear our prayer.
That the dead may share in your glory, the glory too of your Son and the Holy Spirit, we pray.
God of love, hear our prayer.
Father, you sent your word to bring us the truth and your Spirit to make us holy. Help us to worship you, one God in three persons, by proclaiming and living our faith in you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
please all stand.
Pray, brethren, that our sacrifice be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His church, Holy Church.
Sanctify by the invocation of your name, we pray, Lord our God, this oblation of service, and by it make of us with eternal offering to you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Keep up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, for with your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord, now in the unity of a single person, but in a trinity of one substance. For what you have revealed in us of your glory, we believe equally of your Son and of the Holy Spirit, so that in the confessing of the true and eternal Godhead, you might be adored in what is proper to each person. Their unity in substance and their equality in majesty. For this is praised by the angels and archangels, cherubim too and seraphim, who never cease to cry out each day, as with one voice they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. the mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world, and bring into the fullness of charity together with Francis, Benaventura, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may we merit to be co-heirs in our life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, our glory and honors is yours forever and ever. That we may be one with the Blessed Trinity. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that with the help of your mercy we be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to our apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace in unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold you who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. All need prayer against the death penalty. Father, source and giver of life, we lift our hearts and voices to you. Help us to build a society that truly chooses life in all situations. Let our response be, Lord, heal our pain. For those experiencing pain and anguish because of violence and crime, response. For perpetrators and victims of atrocities who both struggle with anger and hatred. For our broken world and chained by the desire for revenge. For our wounded society, misled by the illusion that one must take life in order to defend it. Let us pray together. Help us to make peace. For our country tempted to accept violent revenge. For the conviction to recognize and uphold the dignity of all people. For the wisdom to see poverty, injustice, and lack of educational and employment opportunities as likely causes of criminality. for guidance and compassion in addressing the pain of both victims and perpetrators of wrongdoing. For the fortitude to find solutions that protect the dignity of all people and bring about true reconciliation. For the inspiration to renew society on the basis of love and restorative justice. Let us pray. Father of compassion, you let your rain fall on just and the unjust. Give us a heart like yours, so that we may love as you love, even those who have caused us pain. There is in our land a cry for vengeance and a move to fill up death rows and kill offenders, but disguised as a call for justice. Let true and lasting justice spring forth. Jesus, our brother, you suffered execution in the hands of the powerful, but you did not let hatred overcome you. Help us to reach out to victims of violence so that our enduring love may help heal their wounds. Holy Spirit, Lord and giver of life, you strengthen us in the struggle for justice. Help us to work tirelessly against state-sanctioned death and to renew society in truth, justice, love, and respect, so that violence will cease and peace may prevail. Amen. O Mary, Mother of Life, protect the Filipino people from the forces of death. San Lorenzo Ruiz, San Pedro Calungsod, St. Paul the First Hermit, St. Martin, the patron of sick.
May receiving this sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul as we confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So sa darating po na linggo ay kamistahan na Corpus Christi, katawan at dugo ng ating Panginoong Hesukristo. Kaya bahagi po nito sa darating na Sabado, June 17, ay meron po tayong pagkatapos po ng anticipated mass, 7:30 ng gabi, ay i-expose po natin ang Blessed Sacrament. And at 8 o'clock, magsisimula po tayo ng pagkatanod hanggang alas 5 ng madaling araw. So ang lahat ay inaanyahan na makiisa sa pagkatanod. Yung pong mga organisasyong pangsimbahan ay hinihilingan ng isang oras na makiisa sa banal na pagtatanod. Ang sana po ay, well, depende yun sa inyo. Kung yung namang walang pag-iisang pansimbahan, ay inaan niya din yung makiisa. Pero depende yun sa inyo kung kayo ay magbibigay ng less than an hour or more than an hour. Ang mahalaga po ay makapagtanong tayo mula alas 8 ng gabi hanggang alas 5 ng madaling araw. Yung alas 5 ng madaling araw ay tayo po ay magpo-procession. Dala-dala po natin ang Blessed Sacrament. Hilingin natin na tayo basbasan na mahal na katawan at dugo ng ating Panginoong Jesucristo. At marami tayong dapat na ipagdasal. Ito po ay iba pa sa ating vigil na 7 o'clock in the morning hanggang 7 o'clock in the evening, tuwing Huwebes, no? So tuloy-tuloy pa rin po yun. Kasi naman po ay bilang pakiisa natin sa panalangin natin para sa mga may sakit, at sa mga nag-aalaga sa mga may sakit. No? Ito naman, pagdiriwang natin na darating na Sabado hanggang Linggo ay sa pagdiriwang ng taunang kapistahan ng katawan at dugo ng ating Panginoong Jesucristo. So ang lahat po ay naanyahan na makiisa sa bihilya, sa prosesyon at sa panagamisa sa kalangalan ng banal na katawan at dugo ni Jesus. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go with the love and mercy of the Holy Trinity.
Thanks be to God.